Hello friend, today I am going to explain the example of Bachmann rearrangement. Okay, somewhere the application based example are very important for the Bachmann rearrangement. Let us see what are the example can be like that Bachmann rearrangement. Okay, now in Bachmann rearrangement, oximes are there. Okay, oximes are there. These oximes are treated with the mineral acid. Suppose it is the concentrated H2SO4, it is giving what the amides. Okay, so that rearrangement we have to explain with the help of example. Let us see what can be the example. Firstly, you should know that is what are the oximes. Okay, firstly we should know that is how the oximes are getting formed. After that only we can do proceed. Okay, so when the when the aldehydes are there, okay, carbonyl compound, better you write carbonyl compound, okay, and carbonyl compound is reacting with the hydroxylamine, it will give the oximes. These oximes, when react with the concentrated H2SO4, it gives the amides. Now see the examples here to understand this. I am writing with the example. Suppose I am taking the ketone here, R dash, double bond O, and if you are reacting with the hydroxylamine, so how you can write OH NH2. Okay, so how the OH NH2 will be, you see here this is getting minus H2O. So what is left here? R, C and R dash, right? Double bond O, here N, here is OH, right? Now you see you have to take the concentrated H2SO4. Okay, if you are taking the concentrated H2SO4, so the compound will be formed like here R dash C double bond O, NHR. This is the amides. Now let's see the mechanism. Mechanism is quite important also, because sometimes we don't know that is how to proceed. First of all, you ionize the H2SO4 concentrated. It is a strong, so it will give the H plus and HSO4 minus with irreversible process. After that, I am taking that is oximes I am taking here, and this I am having R, C, here is R dash, double bond N, here is OH, and you are taking H plus, here is the lone pair electron, this lone pair electron will attack here, so R, C, here is R dash, double bond N, here is what will be that is OH2, right? So here will be the positive charge will come, and after that there will be this positive charge has to come here, this bond will shift here to neutralize the positive charge. As a result of here, nitrogen will acquire positive charge. To neutralize the positive charge here, it will add here. So next step, what will be R dash C double bond N, and here is R plus what is here H2O. Okay, now the next step will be, now the we have to understand here the valency, you see 1, 2, 3, so here will be the positive charge. With this positive charge I am taking HOH. So what will happen here, this lone pair electron will attack here, so it will give the another intermediate, and what would be the formula? R dash See, here we can write OH2, right? And here is the double bond N, here is R. Now here is the minus H if you do, so alcohol will form. See how the alcohol R dash C, here is OH, and what will be their double bond is as it is NR. Now the amides has to form. So what will happen, this bond will shift here and it is having lone pair electron that will take. So what is the final product is supposed to come, R dash, here is C, double bond O, here is N, H and R. This is what the amides. So this is the first example of the Beckmann rearrangement. I hope this could be the easy to understand for you. Okay, now let us see the next example, how to understand the one more example I am taking to make the things quite clear. Okay, so suppose I am having this ketone, cyclic ketone, actually this one, this is example number 2, and cyclic ketone is getting reacted with hydroxyl amine. So this is the hydroxyl amine and this oxygen will be like that. So what is happening here, minus H2O, and here oximes will form as usual. So double bond is there, here is double bond NOH. So there is the similar, what will happen here if you are taking H plus, from where it is coming from, H2SO4. So this lone pair electron will attack on this, and what will happen here, let us see, this is the double bond N, here is OH2, this is the positive charge. Okay, now if this is the positive charge, so there will be the loss of water molecule. So here is the minus H2O will be there. Okay, now if the minus H2O will be there, what you can do here, this bond has to expand. Suppose I am writing here, this is there, here is the hydrogens are there, here is also hydrogen, all the places hydrogens are there, here is double bond N is there, but it is having the positive charge because this bond has to shift here. So as a result of this, what will happen, okay, here will be that you take the H2O, so this lone pair electron, this is supposed to attack here. So on this, when you are trying to attack on this, where it will attack, here it will attack on the carbon. Okay, so if it is attacking on the carbon, what the compound is supposed to get here, here will be the, there is no positive charge, this will take the this proton, and what will happen here, it will form the NH, and here will be the O will be, and here is the extra number of the carbon will add here. So 1, 2, 3 carbon will not add as the nitrogen added here. So nitrogen added here, so what is happening here, the number of the ring size increases. So this compound will form, and this compound is known as what, caprolactam. Caprolactam. So sometime example, and this one is known as cyclohexanoxime, and this so cyclohexanone, right? If you that in general, if you want to write the reactions, no need to write the if you don't want to write the mechanism, what you can do, here is O, here is N, here is OH is there, right? If you are treating with the H2SO4, what will happen, the compound will form like this, here is the NH will form, okay, this okay. So if you see here, what is happening? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what will happening? This you take and here will form, here will be double bond. So number of that is like 6, 2, it become the 7. So this is known as what? Caprolactam. So I hope this example may be good for you. Thank you so much for watching, friend.